Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh, and a very good evening. It is a great honor to be given the opportunity to address such a distinguished occasion in conjunction with the World Halal Excellence Award 2020. I would like to take this opportunity to thank Yang Amat Berhormat Prime Minister Tan Sri Muhyiddin Yassin for his firm and unrelenting support and commitment to our cause and efforts in developing the halal industry. This year's conference has invariably discussed and exchanged views on how the industry should address the challenges and opportunities arising from this pandemic that impacts not only public health but the global economy as well. The Halal Development Corporation is tasked to promote and facilitate the expansion and diversification of the halal industry and tap into new markets, products and services. Ladies and gentlemen, as is widely known, the halal market is not confined to the traditional parameters of the food and beverage sector. Thanks to significant advances in R&D, the boundaries have been widened to cover a broad cross-section products including pharmaceuticals and medical devices. In the services sector too, a vast array of the halal ecosystem now incorporates components ranging from financing, marketing and packaging to integrated logistics and electronic media. In other words, the very notion of the boundaries of halal itself has undergone transformation along with the changing times and advances, going beyond food, thus creating exponential growth in the global economy. The halal market is projected to reach a massive $3 trillion by 2030. This is indeed a very promising future for us. In order to unlock the full potential of the halal industry, it is imperative that regulators, industry players, investors, and academia work together to exploit the vast opportunities. Additionally, the halal industry is no more limited to the Muslim market. On the contrary, it is also open to the massive populations of non-Muslims in Asia as well as the West. Today, the adoption of advanced technology and innovation in processing and delivery of products as well as services has never been more profound, as companies ought to go digital out of necessity as well as for greater efficiency and accessibility. As such, the concept of Islamic or halal digital economy should be explored further. By promoting Malaysia as a haven for Islamic digital economy, we would be able to capitalize on various aspects of digital transformation and advances in tandem with the fourth industrial revolution. In this regard, HDC is developing the Halal Integrated Platform, or HIP, targeted to be launched in the first quarter of 2021. HIP will connect local halal industries to global halal players while facilitating companies to grow their business capability and capacity backed by the Malaysian Halal Certification. Halal certified companies on the HIP will be promoted as Malaysia's premium halal produce both in the domestic and international markets. Ladies and gentlemen, the development and promotion of halal parks is an essential component of the enhancement of the halal ecosystem. HDC has so far received 15 billion ringgit in new investments for the halal parks since its first establishment in 2007. I urge halal certified manufacturers, producers and service providers to seriously consider moving to any of the 14 hallmark accredited halal parks. Take this as an opportunity to enhance your value proposition to meet the increased demand for halal certified products and services. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to commend the ongoing work of HDC, which has implemented various initiatives since 2006 to develop the halal industry locally and foster the halal ecosystem at regional and global landscapes. On behalf of MITI and HDC, I would like to congratulate the winners of this year's Halal Excellence Award 2020. You have indeed become the catalyst in your own right, championing the halal market and Islamic economy. In closing, may we supplicate to Allah the Almighty that may He continue to protect each and every one of us, and may He assist us in executing the strategies we have laid out, and may He make it easy for us to achieve our aims and objectives. And finally, if I may say so, while we appreciate the significance of tonight's event, I would like to remind all of us not to let our guard down and to always be extra vigilant in complying with the strict halal health and safety protocols. Stay safe and stay healthy. Thank you. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh.